Hello children, welcome to the SST class. In the previous two sessions, I discussed about teacher, doctor, mobile dispensary and vaccination. Let's have the feedback through questions. Name some helpers. Where does a teacher work? How does a teacher help children? Who teaches good habits to children? How do teachers make subjects interesting? When do we celebrate Teachers' Day? Why do we celebrate Teachers' Day? Where does a doctor work? What does the doctor do when you are sick? How does the doctor treat the wound? What do you mean by vaccination? Name two diseases against which vaccinations are given. What are mobile dispensaries? Who treats sick and injured animals? Children, I hope you are able to answer these questions. Now come to the next topic. Postal workers. Children, do you know which is the common means of sending and receiving messages? Letter is the common means of sending and receiving messages. Who brings letters for us? Postman brings letters for us. When we say the word postman, an image of male comes to our mind wearing the khaki uniform who rides a bicycle. He is a carrier of letters, money orders, invitation cards, parcels and many more. He works in a post office. Let's come to the reading. Before reading, let me discuss some key words. Number 1. Offense. Unlawful act. Number 2. Patrol. To walk regularly through an area to see that all is well. Page 50. Postal workers. Postal workers work in a post office. Cities, towns and villages have post offices. Letters are the most common means of sending and receiving messages. Where do postal workers work? Postal workers work in a post office. Which is the common means of sending and receiving messages? Letter is the most common means of sending and receiving messages. We write letters and post them in a post box. A postal worker collects the letters from the post box and takes them to the local post office. Children, do you know how a postman helps us? After writing letters, we drop them in a letter box. The postman takes out the letters from the post box and carries them to the post office. Here, the letters are sorted out according to the place where they have to be delivered. Underline the word sorted and write down the meaning arranged. ARRANGED, arranged. Then underline the word delivered and write down the meaning handed over. The letters are sorted out in the post office according to the addresses written on the letters. They are then sent to post offices in those places. The postal workers in the post offices, in those places, deliver the letters. They also deliver parcels and money orders. After that, the letters are sent to other places by buses, trains, or aeroplanes. There, the postman delivers the letters at the addresses written on them. This is how a postman helps us. Where do we post letters? We post letters in a post box. Who collects the letter from the post box? A postal worker collects the letter from the post box. How do the postal workers sort out the letters? The postal workers sort out the letters according to the places where they have to be delivered. How do postal workers help us? Postal workers help us to deliver letter, parcels and money orders. Now come to the next topic. Policeman. The policeman works in a police station. He maintains law and order. He also controls the crowd. Page 51, police. All neighborhoods have a police station. Police work here. Police maintain law and order. They see that people follow rules and respect the law. Underline the word follow and write down the meaning. Obey. O-B-E-Y. Obey. Children, as I earlier told you that policeman works in a police station and he is responsible for maintaining law and order in society, as law protects our general safety. What is the duty of police? The duty of police is to maintain law and order and also see that people follow rules. If people do not follow the law, the police take action and punish them according to the offense committed. Underline the word committed and write down the meaning to do something illegal. Children, we must seek the help of a policeman and inform him if we find any problem regarding security, crime and theft, etc. One who does not obey the law is punished by police. What happens when people do not follow rules and respect the law? When people do not follow rules and respect the law, the police take action and punish them. Police help to protect our life and property. We can call the police station whenever there is a problem and we need help. Children, it is because of policemen that our lives and property are safe. A policeman is important for the smooth running of any society. He acts as a savior of society. Police vans patrol the roads in cities. They attend to accident and to any other problems faced by people. Children, generally you see the police vans on the roads. These vans are used by police force to travel through the streets during day and night so that they can maintain peace in the city. It means police vans take rounds through patrolling vans. If any accident occurs on road, then it is their duty to be at the place and to make sure everyone is safe. Name the vans that patrol roads in cities. Police vans patrol the roads in cities. How do mobile police vans help people? Mobile police vans help people by attending the problems faced by people. Traffic police help in regulating traffic so that traffic moves smoothly on roads. Underline the word smoothly and write down the meaning easily. E-A-S-I-L-Y. Easily. In cities and towns, roads are busy. A traffic policeman controls the traffic on busy roads. They help in avoiding traffic jams and accidents. Underline the word avoiding and write down the meaning preventing. P-R-E-V-E-N-T-I-N-G. Preventing. We must follow the rules and instructions of the traffic police. Underline the word instructions and write down the meaning orders. Children, we must obey the traffic policeman to avoid any road accident and for smooth flow of traffic. How do traffic police help on the roads? Traffic police regulate the traffic on the road. I hope you have understood the today's topic. Now, your homework is to read page 50, 51, revise terms and do question number 7 till 10 on page 53. Thank you.